we wanted to do this in a very responsible way. We understand that a lot of people are suffering through this pandemic, and we wanted to make sure that as we reopen, as other businesses do, that we do it in the best possible light. So we have a lot of people coming here, the trainers who spent the winter in Louisiana, maybe Florida. As they've come back, we've put in protocols to do the best we can to ensure that the virus is not spread any further. So everybody who comes to our backside has to be an essential person to the backside operations. So the first time they come, they actually have COVID-19 testing to see whether or not they're negative or positive. Thereafter, every time you come into the track, or if you live at the track, every day, you get your temperature taken, a series of questions, just to sort of see that things are going smoothly. Folks are required to wear face cover-up throughout the protocols. So really social distance from one another. All the things that are being recommended by the public health officials we're trying to do. And we have to remind ourselves every day because it's not natural. We're not used to a lot of these things. But we're all trying to take care of each other and do it in a responsible way. It's definitely been a roller coaster of emotions for everyone, not just us here, but the entire community, the entire nation. But, you know, for us, we feel a very, you know, big sense of responsibility for the people who make their living in this industry. And so for us, it really was a challenge. We wanted to do things right. We wanted to be responsible. And we wanted to get people home. You know, that's really what it was all about. So I'm excited about it. I'm excited that they're here. I'm excited that they have the opportunity to run for purse money so that their businesses can thrive. Today's a good day. Tomorrow's going to be even better. But we're like everybody. That roller coaster of emotion, we did it together. You know, we had the ups and the downs as a team, as a family, and that's how we've been able to come through this.
Kevin, sell this meet to the race fans. They can't be here, so why should they be interested?
Well, this is, first of all, just so unusual. And it's a time, it's that first step to reopening. It's that first step to trying to get back to some norms. We're glad that we've got this content that will be on Fox Sports 1 over the weekend, and it's going to be incredible racing. If you've seen the cards, I mean, Sunday, I believe we have 101 trainers represented on the card, 49 jockeys. I heard Tom Amos speaking earlier. The competition is going to be incredible. Those who love horse racing, you're going to see some fantastic racing. And it's that first step to say, you know what, we're going to be okay with it.
Dr. Fauci and other health experts have expressed pessimism about fans in the stands for major sporting events this summer and early fall. What are the contingency plans for Churchill Downs for the Derby?
So we still have quite a ways until the first Saturday in September, the Derby in September. Our focus is on trying to do it in a responsible way with fans in the stands. As we've said on several of earnings calls and whatnot, we know there's time between today and September 5th. We will be listening to the experts and adjusting as we need to adjust. With everything we do, we probably have 10, 15 scenarios that we just sort of consider because we don't want to be taken by surprise. We're going to be working with government officials, with public health officials, to make sure that we do what we do in a responsible way.
How late can you go? What would be your drop dead, fans or no fans?
You know, I don't know that I have that date in my mind right now, Fred. It's for us, we're focused on throwing the events with fans in a responsible way.